So this is d cube, and like we finished last time, we will continue with the mini games which are remaining. So we completed mini game pack 1 and 2, and now we start with mini game pack 3. So let's see what mini game pack 3 holds. Okay, Walnut Bowling 2. Okay. So this one should be similar to the Walnut Bowling we already had. Let's see. Seeing Stars. Okay. This is where we need to plant the star fruit. And Bobsled Bonanza. Okay, so let's start with Walnut Bowling 2. Okay, so is it like the regular Walnut Bowling, or is there something different about this? Let's check it out. The walnuts seem different. This one seems to be very, very different. That walnut seems bigger, right? I think it does. We'll try it later. During the first wave, maybe. Probably try it now. Nah, let's try. Wait for the wave to hit. Okay, if the space does finish off, we'll try it. If we're out of space on the conveyor belt, we'll look at the new type of walnuts we have right now. We'll just continue with the same old. So there's screen door zombies this time. Last time it was just the newspaper ones. Ooh, so this guy is tougher. Should we try the new one, or let's wait since there's a big wave coming on anyways? Okay, let's hit them with an exploder nut there. Kaboom. Okay, let's see. Oh, big walnut. So that was, it's like a tall nut kind of thing, huge thing. I wonder why they did not design it like the tall nuts, since they already had that design available. Yep. Big nuts for sure. Hello, double star burst. Thanks for raiding me earlier. Much appreciated. So here goes, boom. We are just at the first wave right now. Feels like we have been playing this for quite some time. Boom. Okay. Here goes. That disco did get nutted. Yeah. Okay, this guy is going to go free, not for long though. Ah, the screen door escaped. Ah, the old man with the newspaper is back. Yep. Squash. Yeah, sorry. I'm not a fan of your dancing. Okay. Yep. Oh, why did I get so many coins? We are almost near wave 2 now. Zombies invading my lawn. The pole vaulter came in and well, that's about it for him. Big wave coming in. Oh, this guy's getting near. Okay, so we are almost out of nuts now, so we need to probably save some until the conveyor belt starts loading more of them. Squash. So that newspaper guy is about to lose his newspaper and his school. Yep. Does not matter much anyways. Time to roll over some zombies. Nope, did not work. Okay, we rolled over three of Disco's friends. And now it's time for him to go down. So do we see a Gargantor in the stage? I wonder. Third wave is about to come on. Yep, all disco zombies are done. Yep, big wave comes in. Let's wait to see how it goes down. Okay. So there it is. Take care of that lane. That's where the disco zombie is. Kaboom. Ooh. That last one. Huh. Let's give him some time. Let him enjoy his slow walk of death. So should we destroy him with the giant walnut or should we destroy him with an exploder nut? Ah, let's just squash him. Yep, the trophies are what next? Seeing stars. Okay, so we need to plant all the star fruit before the four waves of zombies are completed. So that's what the primary goal is. So the star should be enough to cover up any damage. So we'll just take an imitator star fruit. The puff shrooms will be there just as cannon fodder. Let's see what else. Let's take the squash. We'll put walnuts up there for defense. can we take? Just the marigold for laughs. I don't want to watch a video to earn a rake. That explode mine just failed, but it's fine. I think it halted this zombie long enough, and that is what the ultimate goal was, anyways. Just continue to plant stars and keep them protected. So it's not like if we lose the stars we lose the game. So we just need to complete planting all the stars before all the waves set in. That's about the only goal of this game. Nobody's attacking this guy. Not good. So we are getting there slowly. So now the stars are starting to fill in and our damage is increasing. Diamond. Big wave coming through, wave number one. We need to complete all the stars before wave four. Seems like quite an easy task, not very difficult. Shh. Star fruits in such large quantity definitely seems to have quite some firepower. Okay, one star to go. That's it. Zombies are down. The trophies are. What next? Bobsled Bonanza, of course. Okay, regular zombies, the Zombonis, and the bobsleds, of course. So we'll need what we need is we need some basic protection in the water, since there are swimming zombies. Maybe the cattails will be fine. Need spike weeds are a must. Spike weeds and spike rocks. Then probably something to slow them down. Snoopy will be fine. Jalapenos, quite good in this level. And we'll go with the cherry bomb for added effects. Start. Oh, there is already some icy trail there. We need to plant everything behind that trail. Gonna be tricky. Here they start. Jalapeno just fries a trail over, so that's a good thing. Unfortunately, we do not have much of it. Oof. We better start planting those cattails. it's four waves here. We need to survive those four waves. Ooh, getting quite close for my liking. Ah, that was very, very lucky, very, very close. It was way too close. Need more of them cattails now. And then we'll start planting some more spike weeds and spike rocks. Okay, so just kind of build them in. So if you can keep the trail short, then it becomes much easier. So that's what we need to concentrate on. Keeping the trail smaller. Use jalapenos to the same effect. Okay, so we're slowly starting to get the hang of this, which is a good thing. So the second wave seems to be coming in now. Zombies are out in full force. Get rid of this guy soon. Especially on that last lane there. I think we can start going in for the snow peas now. Lots of zombonis landing in. The zombie horde is starting to get bigger now. So we need to speed things up a bit. These things will start getting difficult from after the third wave. Those zombies just going into the pool. Look at the number of zombies there. Way too many zombies. We need some more cattails now. DQ, now plant some more cattails, otherwise it's gonna be a bit of a problem for you. Sink them, zombies. Oof, it's starting to lose things in the water. Big wave, it's almost upon us. So this final wave shouldn't be much of a problem as long as we can keep the last two lanes and the first lane intact, because that is where we don't have the lawnmowers. The rest of them are fine in general. The final wave was very tame comparing it to the other waves that we just went through. Boom. So we completed all three games in minigame pack 3. Let's go to minigame pack 4. Invisigold. Okay, so there are invisible zombies in this one. Last stand, of course, where we need to build our defense with limited amount of sun. And Zombot need 2. And they have Zombot Net 2 is much more tougher than the first one. Let's play Invisigold for now. So here it is, invisible zombies. There are two zombies there. Three shrooms are the ones that reveal their location. Wonder where this next zombie is coming from. Apparently from there. Luckily our plants are not as blind as we are. We need a pea shooter in that first lane. Don't have anything to protect there. Nor in the water. We need to also build something in the water. So far nothing in the water. So now at least we have a full lane of offensive plants. Now we can take it from here. Let's keep this until the first wave hits. We aren't in any immediate danger of losing. So let's keep that there at the moment. Oof. Zombies seem to have increased now. Could we use the free room? There's just that. Okay, does it not freeze the zombies in the water? Is really strange. But does not show the water zombies at all. Is that a metal zombie? Not good. Seems to be a buckethead there. Not good for us. Reached till the end of the lane. Oof. Is there more than one zombie there? Goes down. Oh no. And we are going to lose our pool cleaner. Yeah. Oh, not good. Now we need desperately a zombie there. Uh-oh, Jack in the Box. I mean, they're already very difficult and now they're invisible as well. Dolphin zombie. Do not tell me there are zombonis here now. Things keep getting worse. And we don't seem to be getting any new pea shooters. Ah, finally one. Come on. Ah, finally. Something worked. Okay. We just lost another lawnmower and the final one is yet to come. Come on, we cannot plant anything there. Why can't we plant anything there? This is the best way to deal with the suckers. Final wave is going to be here soon. Need to protect those second and fourth lanes because that is where maximum damage is. There are no lawnmowers. Just free some zombies. I wonder why the freezing does not work in the waters. Come on. There's just one plant left, one zombie left, and we're going to lose this level. That was the worst fate of all. Let's try this again. Where else are the zombies? That's it. Some lily pads fast, because the water is the most trickiest part. We lost most of our force in the water. Just going to plant a tall walnut there, but at least keep it safe until pea shooter shows up. Okay, now we have pea shooters in every lane. Okay, let's freeze these guys. We have walnuts now everywhere, so we are more protected now than before, and the water invasion has started. lost at Walnut there. Squash had the front line of offense. Should do the trick. So big wave is coming in now. Good, not good, not good. I think this is the dolphin zombies. We really need a squash now. Here goes nothing. Force are considerably stronger this time. We haven't lost any of our last defenses. So I think we could probably win this game. At least I feel so. Oh no. The jack in the box. Hope it does not reach the end there. Yeah, that should stop him. So at least this time we got the freeze room at the right time. Now we need a squash. That first lane there. No, in the second lane actually. Okay, there it goes. Okay. Oh no, there's something there. Okay, come on, squash, baboom. Keep your squash there just in case. Final wave, as destructive as it sounds. Okay, now is the right time for a fish room to show up. That was a jack in the box, would have been trouble if he had landed. Free shroom. Yep. This is it. This game is ours to win. do you even lose from here? Okay. Another diamond, another trophy. Okay, last stand. So let's play. We have already played the last stand puzzle games. So this is the pool. Let's see how we survive this one. So of course we cannot take any sun plants. Puff shrooms and all the free plants are grayed out. Okay. So there's ladder guys here. Which is kind of bad news for everyone. Football zombies are going to be causing some trouble. Jack in the box, screen door zombies, bucket heads. Really powerful players. How much sun do we get here? It depends on it. There is no real point of planting any defensive plants if the ladder zombies are going to be waltzing around. We can take the corp cannon, but is it really worth it? That is the most important thing. Maybe we can try to get these people in one lane with the garlic, but then they'll soon overwhelm us. Let's see if we can get enough brand the coffin, or we'll just take the jalapeno and cherry bomb combo. Okay, we have 5,000 sun. That's plenty of it. Let's see now. 1950. We should just restart, and maybe since we have got 5,000 sun, maybe take the snow peas. Oh, what should we do? Let's just go. Can we remove this guy? Okay, so we have to restart it. Let's just make the build out of melon pulse. And then put cattails. We'll take the repeater just in case, but I don't think we are going to be able to get enough sun to use it. What should we do? Yeah, let's do it this way. Melon pulls everywhere. Yeah, let's go with this. Let's just start it off. We'll see how it works. So I think there are 5 waves, so we need to survive all 5 waves for victory. So at least in this first wave, does not look like we need any kind of help. The melon pulls are just doing their part without any hassle. So, of course, the football zombie, as usual, causes a bit of trouble. But that's just the football zombie, extremely overpowered being. They should really consider nerfing that football zombie. He seems too powerful compared to the other zombies. Because he is the fastest of those zombies, and he also has, you know, toughness. So probably they remove either one of the attribute. I can understand the Gargantor being powerful because he is the Gargantor after all. So now what? So more winter melons. Okay, so far there's not much we need to do, just wait and watch. Okay. Those football zombies are getting dangerously close. Should we plant a jalapeno? I guess we better. Lost quite a bit of sun, but at least we survived. Okay, one more winter melon and we continue this. The football zombies are the bane of existence. Just when I took its name, here it is. It's not even slowed down as of yet. Oh man. Come on, do not lose. Oof. He managed to protect the zombies right behind him. And here come some more football zombies. So this strategy obviously did not work for us. So we need to try something else. So we'll try the repeater Gatling Torchwood strategy this time. And if that does not work, we'll try a kind of combo and see how that does. So here we go. Okay, so we still need to plant one more repeater. After this, we could probably try using garlics and getting all of them into the middle lanes. That strategy has worked in the past, so we could do that. Possibly. The first waves do seem to be easier. It's the later waves that trouble starts. Okay, so are the repeaters better than the winter melons in taking down the football zombie? Apparently looks so, because the football zombies were making it to the end, even with the winter melons slowing them down, but this time they were destroyed halfway through. Okay, so this strategy seems to be working fine, at least in the second level. It's the third level where we had lost the last time. So that is where we'll be focused on. big wave is coming. Football zombies no match for our flaming pea shooters. Okay, but that screen door zombie could cause a bit of a problem. Okay. So one Gatling pea is all that we can hold at the moment. Just go with it. Don't think we need to plant anything in the more Gatling peas in the water just yet. Probably later we'll need some. Only thing that these repeaters do not have is pierce damage. Others, they could have been quite the force. Big wave coming in. Let's see how our warriors stand up against this. Oh, that dreaded dolphin zombie loses its head before it makes it halfway through. So I think quite good, quite good. I think there are lesser football zombies then in our last encounter, because there are definitely more of them in our last playthrough. I don't know if they've been lowered or what has happened, but they definitely seem to be less in number. Whole lot of zombies coming in, whole lot of zombies getting fried. Okay, so there it is, the football zombie charging in and losing his head in a blaze of glory. The big wave strikes, two dolphin riders. Very, very dangerous, but only with when their heads are on. Okay, let's go under wave. So it does not look like any of these zombies are going to really make a dent in our plants. Okay, but now the football zombies have started to come in bigger numbers. Big wave comes in. Think we are good for this. Boom. Yep, victory is ours. So now we go on to Zombotany 2. Okay, let's go for Zombotany 2. This is going to be quite difficult. And Zombotany 1 was difficult enough. Ooh, jalapenos, squashes, Gatling peach, tall nuts. Wow. This is going to be tough, quite tough. Okay, so we're going to use the garlic like we did last time. Hopefully this time it works. Let's see. Thank you, Hunden IRC, for following. Okay, need to plant a cattail soon. Or maybe we can just get rid of that lawnmower. So we'll just try to plant cattails. I don't know how they do underwater, these zombies. So we'll try to increase the production underwater. So now they've started coming in underwater as well. So we better increase the defenses there. Come on. Yeah, right on time. So this is a good strategy to have, just to, you know, keep things one lane. This is better than Zombotany 1, where we had to stay on land. Cattails do great damage here in the water. choosing spike weeds is great, but here come some tall nuts. This game is going much better than I thought, at least so far. I felt Zombotany 1 was much more trickier. But I'm still worried about the jalapeno zombie showing up. Hopefully it did not destroy my lane of sun. It'll probably be showing up soon. There it comes. So we managed to survive the first jalapeno. There comes the Gatling pea, exactly where we want him. Wave 2 is hits right now, and the squash is gone as well. Ooh, the jalapeno zombie. Somebody needs to take care of him soon. No. Please take care of the jalapeno zombie. Oh gosh. We just lost our entire offensive line there. Thankfully, the other line still stands. Okay, we just lost the garlic to the squash. Weird. This game has gone on great so far. Except for the slight mishap with the Jalapeno, it has been quite good. Yeah, that's the problem with having the jalapeno with the cattails. They do attack all lanes, but they target the nearest zombie rather than the most dangerous one. Sometimes that does not always work. So that was lucky. We were going to have another jalapeno mishap there. Okay, final wave coming in. That Gatling guy is, oh my gosh, they're about to lose a lot of sun there. Again, that problem where the cattail targets the nearest zombie rather than the most dangerous one. So Zombotany 2 is done as well. Okay, so we are going in for the final pack. So Big Old Twist, Pogo Party, and Zombie Nimble Zombie Quick. So let's start with Big Old Twist. So let's start this off. Oops. How do we do this? Okay, so that okay. Okay, finally it worked. Okay. Finally, some semblance. Okay, this isn't working. Oof. Okay. Okay. So why am I not able to move those plants there? Oops, this game is quite tricky. See the controls, I'm not sure what it is, but just does not seem to be working. We still have that crater to fill, but I want to upgrade my plants before I do anything. Okay. Full that newspaper zombie causing quite a lot of problems there. Really need to fill those gaps now. Because this go becomes some trouble. Need to fill those where there are three craters. That is going to be a lot of trouble. Still do not really understand the concept of this because, as far as I can see, there does not seem to be any resemblance to the matchups. Okay. So here we get quite a lot. So just I don't seem to be able to push this one. Oh my gosh. Finally, some semblance. How do we even win this now? Okay, so the zombies are definitely increasing. We are in quite a lot of trouble here. Some big trouble. I don't think they are going to be able to upgrade the repeater, so we might as well stick with the plans that we have and make the best of it. Unfortunately, it does not look like we are going to win this one. We have no possible moves. Oh, that was brutal. Let's try this again. Okay. So this is definitely more trickier than the normal Big Old game. I'm just starting to get the hang of it a bit. Quite tricky. Okay. Sometimes the directions don't really make sense. No, the that is where it becomes a bit tricky. Gosh. The zombies ate one of my plants again. Okay, that's good. So we did quite a lot of matches this time. Okay. Here goes nothing. It's a bit more, a lot more trickier than the normal Big Old, which is quite easy to understand. It's just match of three. Here you need to do a bit of a twisting motion, which can be tricky to understand. Tips given are not very clear either. No, in Big Old, the tricks given were quite clear as to what you need to do. Here it's not that easy to understand, make out. That's why it gets a bit more difficult. Hopefully we can get the repeater this time. Okay, so again that big wave comes in which destroyed us last time. Hopefully this time we can survive it. Doing quite better, more progress than what we had last time, so that's that. Just not liking the mechanics to this game. We lost a lot of sun, so I think we cannot really get the repeater. We can just focus on getting the other things done. So now what? Okay. Come on. So is there anything at all we can do right now? Here goes nothing. Another big wave coming in, which means trouble for us. Making a 75 is quite the tricky part. That was good. So we are almost at the end. Hopefully we can survive. Now the waves are starting to build up. So we really need to do something faster. Cannot lose after coming so far. Unfortunately, the football zombies cause quite some problem. The zombies are getting faster as well. Almost at the end. No possible moves. I think we are going to lose this one as well. So near yet so far. Oof. Okay, let's try this one later. right now, let's try the other mini games. Maybe need to stretch a bit before we go into it. Let's play Pogo Party. So I think the mini game pack 5 is the most difficult one. With all these pogo zombies, it definitely looks crazy. So I think let's see. Tall nuts will be mandatory here since it's Pogo Zombies. Chompers. Then maybe squashes. So far no pogos in sight, but they're going to come for sure. Just like that, they're gone. So this time, I'm going to stop him. Thank you, Boria 2005, for following. Sure, I'll do it right after this game. Oops, oopsie daisies, come on. पी कभी ओके माय मैग्नेट स्ट्रूम माय मैग्नेट स्ट्रूम डज नॉट सीम टू बी यू नो रेडी येट. यस ऑफ कोर्स बोरिया 2005 आई विल फॉलो यू ऑन ट्विच. ओके थैंक यू मेक श्योर टू फॉलो यू. Okay, sure, Boria, once this game is done, I will follow you back. So now I think we can concentrate on getting some more. Huge wave is coming. Does not sound good at all. Sure, Boria, I'll follow you. Yes, when I finish, I will follow you. It's good stuff. Okay. our chompers get busy. Pogo party so far is fine. Then the magnet shrooms being there help a lot. But once we have a row full of tall nuts, I don't really think it even really matters. Second wave coming in. Loads more normal zombies as well as pogos. So let's see how our team lasts against this one. Boy, just lost some. Here they go. Oh boy. Just lost the tall nut there. Final wave is going to be here soon. Need to strengthen our defenses before that. Especially in that first lane. The fifth lane and the second lane do not worry me as much because we have our roof cleaners over there. But the other lanes are a bit problematic on the whole. these lanes are in trouble now. Third lane really needs some power backing. Okay. And that last lane is done for. I don't think anything can save it at the moment. But at least we have that roof cleaner there, so it should be fine. Okay, pogo part is done. Zombie nimble, zombie quick. Let's try this. Faster zombies. Faster zombies are dangerous zombies. Definitely need tall nuts in this stage considering dolphin riders and the javelin zombies are both there. Other than that, it's not very difficult. Just put the Snoopy in to slow them down. Okay, let's go. So the zombies and the plants are both faster. Now is the right time to plant a cattail. This thing is getting weirdly fast. Oh boy, speed keeps on increasing. wave coming in. Oh, right on time there. Those dolphin riders are terrible. So now that we have some tall nuts everywhere, we can breathe a bit easy at least. Okay, but if they attack us too fast, then it will be problematic again. It's getting faster and faster. Light speed. Planting those extra tall nuts were effective. The zombies are increasing and they're getting more and more difficult to control. Third wave coming in. So it is definitely more difficult in the water than it is on land, what I can see. Is it because I do not have any snow peas in the water? Is that why this is? I don't know. Either way, it definitely looks much more stressful in the water. So maybe I will plant some snow peas in the water to slow the enemies down. Final wave is coming in. Huge wave. Oh, we lost a cattail there. And we lost both our snow peas. But I think this game is as good as in the bag. Okay, so we'll give Big Old Twist one last try. After that, we give up for today. Just going to randomly push these things because I'm not sure how else to do it. Why is this not moving? Definitely showed me that there was a possibility there. Okay. We already lost. That's not good at all. They're losing things more rapidly this time. No possible moves this time. They're doing even worse this time than we were doing last time. Visual twist. I still don't understand the mechanics of visual twist, to be honest. Seems to be other than normal. I mean, so for visual it was quite easy. You just match three and that takes care of things. Here it isn't that way. You need to twist and make some kind of combination, which I really don't understand how it works. If anyone knows how this works, please let me know in the comments below. Okay, so there it is. So we'll try to fill in some the creators now. We just got another creator. So our task just became void. So at least we managed to fill all our creators now. But we are only at 32 matches. This is not good on the first wave. Don't really understand how this twisting mechanism works. Which is causing quite a bit of trouble. Okay, come on. So what else? Okay. 55 matches so far. So is that good? I don't know. Big waves coming in. Just hope we make it through. Come on, hint please, hint please. Now what? Oh, we just lost. Made two craters there. That's not good. I think we are again going to same pattern there. Where we lose more in the towards the end. Come on, they showed me something but it did not work. Okay. This is getting tricky. Is it that wave again where there are multiple football zombies? Okay. Oh gosh, 70. Come on, 72. Really need, oh my gosh, 74, one last, woof, ouch. I'll probably need to watch a couple of videos from other players to learn how to actually play big old splits, but for now we beat all the mini games and that's it, we are done with thing. Congratulations, you have collected all the trophies for now. Okay, so puzzles done, mini games done, survival is survival, so we have completed survival as well. So nothing else really remains, a few achievements here and there, but overall we've done quite well. So we have completed around 80% of our achievements as well, and we have completed all the levels in Plants vs Zombies 1. So for now we'll stop here, and of course we'll continue with Plants vs Zombies 2 tomorrow, and then maybe we'll start with some other games as well. So thank you everyone for joining. Make sure to follow, subscribe and cheer, and of course we'll continue playing and we'll continue enjoying. Right now before we sign off, as usual we'll check for some channel which is playing Plants vs Zombies and raid them, and then we'll go our way and I'll meet you back tomorrow. Let's see who we can raid who's playing Plants vs Zombies. Okay, El Nacho LV seems to be playing it, so we'll raid him. Okay, we are starting the raid right now. So thank you everyone for joining. As mentioned, please make sure to follow and subscribe, and also your cheers are important. So thank you all and stay strong, stay safe, peace out.